Let's get infinite resources and crafting materials in Assassin's Creed Valhalla using cheating. But first, if you're new to the channel, hit the subscribe button and the little bell so you'll be the first to know when I release more videos like this. And I also don't want to waste your time, so I want to make it clear now that you need the PC version of Assassin's Creed Valhalla for this to work. If you're rocking a version of one of the consoles, that's awesome. I love consoles too, but unfortunately the stuff that I'm about to show you in this video is not going to work for you. But hey, maybe stick around anyway and find out why you should consider making the switch over to PC gaming. Alright, that said, let's get into this. First thing you'll want to do is load Cheat Engine and Assassin's Creed Valhalla. And if you don't have Cheat Engine, I've got a link in the video description below to another video showing you how to get set up in 5 minutes. Okay, before you do anything else, back up your save, which I've already done for my game. And now just pick a save you want to use for infinite items and load it up. And once you see your main character loaded and you can move around, head over to Cheat Engine and click the little computer icon, then double click AC Valhalla. And double check up here to make sure the game is attached. Okay, we're going to mod our silver first, just because it's the easiest item to get. But if you don't have at least 15 to 30 silver, you probably need to get some more in the game first. Then head over to a shop. And when you get there, take a look at how much silver you have. In my case, it's 73. Type that number into the scan box over here and hit first scan. And let Cheat Engine do its thing. And one of these 50,000 results will be our silver. So let's buy something in the game to change the silver amount. And then take the new silver amount, which is 71 for me, and type that in over here and hit next scan. And this looks a lot better. So let's click the values in black that aren't changing and hit this little red arrow to add them down here. Now to figure out which one of these is our silver, we just need to start changing values and seeing if our silver changes in the game. I'll select the first half, double click the value highlighted in dark blue, and change the value to, say, 100. And in the game, I'll leave the shop screen and then load it back up. And we see that silver is still 71. But over here in Cheat Engine, all these other values changed, and only one still matches the silver in the game. So I'll change this value to 200 and let's see if it changes our silver. There we go. So this value with 200 is definitely the one controlling silver, so I'll double click it in the description column and call it silver. Alright, now a little housekeeping down here to clean this up. Okay, and with this, we can give ourselves as much silver as we want. And we could repeat this process for all the other items, but that would end up being pretty time consuming, especially because the addresses where the values get assigned to will change. But the game code that's controlling silver will never change, except possibly when you download game updates and patches. And to make this even better, the same code controls all our other resources and crafting materials too. I can fetch this if you want. So if we create a quick script that we can turn on or off whenever we want that modifies the game code, we won't need to rescan for values every time we want to do this. First, we need to find the game code that controls our items. To do that, right-click and choose Find Out What Writes to This Address. You'll see a confirmation to attach a debugger to the game. Before you click Yes, head to your Cheat Engine settings and then click Debugger Options and check if Use VEH Debugger is selected. If not, click the circle next to it to select it. Then hit OK at the bottom to save any changes, and now you can right-click again, choose what writes to, and click Yes. Then the debugger window opens with nothing in it. To make something appear, we need to buy something in the game. And if I drag the window back up, we see something here now. You might not see this exact code in your game, but as long as you chose the right address that controls your silver, you're fine. To modify the code, highlight it, and then click Show Disassembler. This loads up a new window with a whole bunch of code in it. The code for the items is the one selected by default. Keep it selected and then come up to click Tools, and then down here, click Auto Assemble. In this new window, click Template, then AOB Injection. Now just click OK once, then type in a name without any spaces, and click OK again. And now we can close out these other windows and get them out of our way. Alright, and here we need to come just behind code and hit enter. Then just copy this first line of code here and paste it just above, and then come just after the comma and remove the stuff before it, but leave the MOV and keep the space between the MOV and whatever you have here in orange. To be clear, if you don't see this RAD, don't type that in. Keep whatever you see in orange behind the comma below for you. Then click just after it and type in a comma and then the number symbol and type in how much silver you want. But keep it below 10 million or your XP might go negative, and the game will change it to less than 10 million anyway when you reload it, so just keep it below 10 million. And that's it. Now just hit File and assign a current cheat table. Now just click the X to close this, and the script we just made is down here. You can give it a name, and then to activate it, just click inside the square. And now we test it. Let's keep an eye on silver while I buy something. And take a look at all that silver. And as long as the script is activated, my silver won't change. No matter what we buy. Alright, we can save the script by hitting the cheat engine and clicking File, Save, and then Save again. And now, anytime we open a blank copy of Cheat Engine, we can click the folder icon at the top and load the infinite item script. But because we only wrote one line of code to keep this fast and easy, the script has a few quirks that you need to be aware of. So I'll walk you through each item real quick, starting with crafting resources. So right now I have 25 leather and 40 iron. If I go to upgrade my quiver, you'll see that I can't. That's because I don't have enough leather. And the code we wrote won't work unless you're able to upgrade something first. But make sure you have at least one more than the required amount to upgrade an item. For example, for this, I need 10 iron and 25 leather so I can upgrade. But if I upgrade right now, I have exactly 25 leather. So the script won't stop me from reaching 0 leather. Now, we could fix this, but it would take a much higher level of coding knowledge to do so. And this video is intended to be approachable for everyone. So I'll reload this. And to get around this issue, we just need to get more of the item in the game, or choose a different piece of equipment that requires less resources. And for the axe, I have at least 31 iron and 11 leather, so this should work perfectly. And again, the script doesn't work if you can't upgrade. So I'll load a save where I have 3 cloth, and now I can upgrade my quiver, which only requires 2 cloth, and as you can see, the script now works. And for infinite titanium, we need a blacksmith to upgrade our armor. So let's head to one. And I've made sure that I have at least one more of each raw material than I need for each upgrade. And as you can see, once you get just a little bit of the resource, the script takes care of the rest. Now we have plenty of materials to upgrade whatever we want. And if I go back and keep upgrading armor, we've got titanium taken care of. And now all we have left is the resources. And really, nothing new here. Just make sure you have enough resources to build something in your settlement. And now we have as much of every resource as we could ever want. Except opal. That's a server-sided value. So we can't change that, unless we break into Ubisoft headquarters to steal it, which I don't advise. But we can still max out all our gear. And when combined with the XP script I covered in the last video, you can quickly become extremely powerful with a lot less tedious money. And don't worry, if you missed the video where I show you how to get infinite XP, that video should be coming up on your screen right about now. As always, if you have any questions, let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching. See you next time.